While there may be much more important things for me to accomplish in life, according to some people, I really want to be able to audition for The Voice. And though it may not happen right now, within the next 10 years, if things are able to work themselves out, I will stand in front of four esteemed artists and sing my lungs out. While I know I wouldn't win because there's so many better artists and singers than I who want to win more than I would just want the experience and the adrenaline rush of being able to sing in front of an audience that size. Not to mention four top singer-songwriters who have fought their way to the top and are willing to coach amateur singers who want a shot at fame. Ever since I was little, up to about 9th grade, I wanted to create and sing music for a living when I grew up, so I was in choir for 12 consecutive years, including kindergarten, until I realized that I wasn't good enough to go on to sing as a career. Even though my focus has shifted now onto more visual art, I still love singing, and most definitely want the opportunity to show music icons what I'm made of, even if it doesn't go anywhere as far as a career. Lots of people don't see me as outgoing enough to sing, especially in front of a crowd of people. They see me as very shy and awkward. I want to prove them wrong and show people that have doubted me that there is more to me than a weird loner who is really good at drawing. I want to prove to myself more than anything, though, that I can excel in so much more than just visual art. When I think about singing in front of a crowd that size on TV, it puts a big smile on my face and a big adrenaline rush through my head. I still sing in the shower in my room and annoy the crap out of my upstairs neighbors, so at some point in my life... And speaking of visual art being my main focus now, the thought of being a tattoo artist makes me really excited. I'm already really good at art and have done dozens of Sharpie tattoos for people at several different events. The pictures you see are some examples of my work on people. I want to go to college for studio art, but if I were to have the chance to be an apprentice for a tattoo artist, not only would I gain knowledge about the technique, art, and business, but it would be a valuable life experience of how to deal with customers from a business perspective, and it would also be really fun. I've always thought that my artwork is basically useless because it serves no useful purpose, but with a tattoo, people find happiness within themselves for getting something permanently stamped onto their body, and I would feel much better about doing something useful if I was a tattoo artist. Plus, with a portfolio and a tattoo art, my range of job availability would increase about twice as much, because people would trust my ability to do art for commissions for them in different mediums. The thought of a tattoo art has always been very interesting to me and aesthetically pleasing to look at and make. It makes me feel the same kind of on fire as the season finale of Gossip Girl would make a white girl obsessed with a show feel. Art always has and will continue to be the main focus in my life that keeps me. As far as career goes, I'm pretty set with the visual art line of work. But as far as my hobbies go, my biggest goal is to become a great cook through lots of practice, like cooking dinner for my family, baking things for fun, and learning the chemistry that goes into finding the exact measurements to make food have the correct consistency and taste. I want to expand and figure out what tastes good together to create my own recipes. Cooking is so interesting. The fact that you can mix together flour, sugar, butter, and water and it suddenly becomes a compact dough is amazing to me. I only started to actively cook about a year ago, and I have gotten really into it, especially after watching season 6 of MasterChef. After learning the techniques, I would need to be able to make the decisions on my own, in a kitchen on my own. My ultimate goal would be comparable to my aunt's ex-husband's new husband. His name is Will, and from what I've heard, he's an artist with the physical aspect of his food looking gorgeous, leaving people to wonder how he did that. While the inside is magnificent, every detail paid very close attention to in appearance, taste, texture, and small traces of happiness. That's what I want to be able to do, host dinner parties in my nice house, making everyone drop their job My goals for proving things to myself and others have been covered, but what I've always found really awesome was the idea of owning exotic pets, whether they be rare breeds of cats or dogs. But while most people are satisfied with a nice cat, dog, bird, or rabbit, pets that are fascinating to me and that I someday would want to own are a skunk and an alligator. I know, it sounds nuts. It probably wouldn't be a good idea to own both of them at the same time because of the raging carnivorous behavior of an alligator, but each animal has their own unique qualities that would make them very fun and educational to own. Obviously, the skunk would have to get sense glands removed. But skunks are very curious and sweet creatures who like to get into trouble and cuddle. Plus, they're adorable the way they walk, with a little waddle and their tail high in the air. It's almost like having a cat with a big fluffy rug of fur and the face of a ferret. The alligator is not as cuddly, with no fur at all. But the smaller versions of alligators are still social beings, unlike their larger cousins. A deep bond can still be built with a creature that is thought of as a killer. With the right amount of affection, even though I would still definitely take caution around him or more safe, or her, a stress-free relationship full of care, love, and playfulness can be built. To have a bond with an exotic pet such as a skunk or an alligator is to become a patient, strong, caring, thoughtful person who can build a meaningful link with another. Before I die, it has been a big personal goal of mine since I was around 12 years old to travel and tour Japan, mostly because of my newfound obsession with anime at the time. Japan has some of the most beautiful landscapes found nowhere else in the world. Not just the natural land, but the style of buildings and culturally unique shrines or exquisite and physical looks, but also what they represent to the Japanese. The Japanese are known for their culture, as they have the most eccentric, beautiful, fierce, innovative, and sometimes just plain weird cultures in the whole world. If something is overly weird or something that no one else would ever have thought of to do, people just say, yep, the Japanese did it, it's their fault. I would love to explore the temples of Kyoto and Hokkaido, the cities of Tokyo and Osaka, experience the shows and entertainment of the graceful geishas, and sightsee the countryside of Okinawa. But not only is the country naturally gorgeous, the people there and their traditions that have remained for the most part intact for centuries are more fascinating. The people there are artists, innovators, creators, monks, storytellers, sumo wrestlers, gardeners, chefs, performers, and so much more. What better way to achieve all my goals than stated previously than to be immersed in a culture where all of them are encouraged? What better way to become an excellent cook than to learn from the masters who have learned from their masters how to prepare a meal fit for a king, and to figure out recipes only present in Japan? And what better way to get the feeling of accomplishment than to witness temples and people that have been around for more than 1,000 years? That gives one the sense that all is one, and one is all.